Washington football fans, welcome to another video here on the Washington Football Maniacs YouTube channel. Please like, share, subscribe if you possibly can. And with that said, let's get into today's video. So Ron Rivera, is his seat hot? Now, if you ask around with a lot of Washington football fans right now, they're going to say, oh yes, that seat is hot. I mean, it's toasty. It's blistering. Ron Rivera is in trouble. You ask the sports media around the DC area, they're probably not going to tell you much about that. They're probably going to say that, yes, they've asked the question, or they don't get the sense that Ron Rivera's in trouble with his job. And honestly, you sit down and look at it right now, he's a year and a half, a season and a half into his coaching tenure here at the Washington football team. Why would his seat be hot at this point? Now you may go back and say, well, wait a minute, Greg, what about Steve Spurrier? Yes, we're going way back then. He only coached for two seasons and he was out. I believe, though, Steve Spurrier quit. Then you look at Jim Zorn. Well, come on. Jim Zorn was in over his head to begin with. We all knew it. I mean, at least Ron Rivera's had head coaching experience, and he's even gotten his team into the Super Bowl. So, come on. I mean, to me, that's apples and oranges. I don't think that Ron Rivera has anything to worry about with his job at this point. Let's also break this down as well. You look at last year's season. All right, so I'm not saying that Washington had an easy season last year as far as schedule, because it wasn't, but it wasn't a first place schedule either. You know, Washington played a lot of teams that were frankly beatable teams, and you know, they took care of business after they started out at 2-6. So, you know, right now, Washington, we all knew, folks, we all knew going into this season that the Washington football team was going to have to play a brutal schedule. And it has been a very brutal schedule. Yet a lot of us, myself included, was pinning Washington as winning at least 8 games this season. Talk about being very optimistic. You know, new quarterback that has not even played for us at all this year. You know, just the numerous amount of injuries. Our kicking team has been suspect. So, I mean, were we being unrealistic in the very beginning? I think we were, probably. At least, I probably was. Now, there are a lot of fans out there who are like, no, this team's not going to win more than 6 or 7 games. And right now, that's probably being very optimistic. I mean, you know, I have to say. Now, Washington could possibly go on a nice win streak, you know, maybe beat Carolina, who knows, with Seattle. Depends on if Russell Wilson is back or not, but, you know, they could beat teams like that. They may wind up sweeping the NFC East games. Who knows? I don't think it's going to be enough this year, however, to win the division or even make the playoffs. And quite frankly, if Washington was able to go on this tremendous run like they did last year, would it be hurting themselves more than helping? Now, there's two ways to look at that. You can look at it strictly from the tank point of view and say, well, you know, at this point, you really don't want Washington to win very many games because you want them to be as high in the draft order next year as possible so we can make sure that we get the quarterback that we need to get. On the other hand, you will also feel like there is a lot more work to be done, that maybe the players that we do have currently are just, you know, maybe we picked the wrong players. Or, you know, possibly. So there's two ways to look at that. You don't want to end season two as if you're just as far behind or further behind than what you thought you were at the end of season one. So even with Ron saying it's going to take 3 to 5 years, well, next year's the third year. So you do expect there to be major marked improvements in season three. And I think it is not selfish or it's not, what's the word? Just, well, put you this way. I don't think it's out of the norm to expect the team that by season three, they should be able to start competing. You know, they should be a team that is right there on the cusp of being a playoff team, if not in the playoffs at that point. Now, you know, by season five, they should be able to compete as being one of the best teams in the league. If we're truly going to give Ron Rivera 5 years, then that's what we should expect as Washington football fans. We should expect by the end of season five that this team is a contender for the Super Bowl. I think anything less than that would be uncivilized, but I think anything less than that would be a huge disappointment, and we would have felt like we have wasted 5 years in the Ron Rivera era. Now, mind you, I am still a huge fan of Ron Rivera. I think he's going to turn this thing around. I have not given up on him yet. I do find it kind of odd, but yet I don't, that there are a lot of fans out there who have already given up on him after one season and a half. Knowing that we've had issues at quarterback, yes, maybe they could have moved up and gotten a Matt Jones. Who knows? Maybe they should have. Well, I don't even know if they would have had to have moved up to have gotten Matt Jones. But regardless, yeah, you know, they could have been a little more aggressive with getting a quarterback this past year, possibly. But, you know, what's done is done. I mean, there are a lot of other teams that chose not to get quarterbacks when they probably needed one. It happens, guys, okay? I mean, look, I really feel like we're going to get the quarterback we need. Obviously, I don't think anybody was against the idea of Ryan Fitzpatrick, you know, running the ship until we were able to draft a quarterback. And I also, maybe this is a video for another day. Maybe I'll do this video tomorrow. But maybe had, you know, Ryan Fitzpatrick not gotten hurt, things could have been a lot different. And maybe we would not have been as hard on Ron Rivera as what we are right now. Anyway, that's what I got today, folks. You know, a lot of you guys are going to say, yes, his seat's hot. I disagree. I don't think his seat is hot. I think it's ice cold for now. And especially with this possible congressional hearing, you know, let's just say Dan Snyder is not worried about Ron Rivera right now. Dan Snyder is probably worried about Dan Snyder. That being said, again, I hope you enjoy this video. Please like, share, subscribe, leave me a comment. What do you think? Do you think Ron Rivera's seat's hot? Do you think it's ice cold? Do you think it's lukewarm? Let me know in the comments. As always, take care. I'll see you in the next one.